Good morning, friends. It is Phil here giving you your daily dose of good news in the morning. And today we're going to find Jesus on the last day of a festival. And have you ever started a show halfway through and, you know, the ending statement, the climax hits and you don't really get it because you missed the first half? This scene that we have here kind of requires some context. We need to know some things. Let's read a couple of verses and then let's see what we can learn from it. It says here in John 7, verses 37, on the last day, the climax of the festival, Jesus stood and shouted to the crowds, "Anyone who is thirsty may come to me. Anyone who believes in me may come and drink. For the scriptures declare rivers of living water will flow from his heart." When he said living water, he was speaking of the Spirit who would be given to everyone believing in him. But the Spirit had not yet been given because Jesus had not yet entered into his glory. Okay, how do we draw the most meaning from this? A couple of things. First off, this festival that the Jewish people were celebrating was remembering a time thousands of years before where God had used a guy named Moses to supernaturally produce water for the people of Israel so that they could live and survive in the wilderness. They were starving and hurting from dehydration, and God provided water for them. Jesus chooses this moment in a bit of a dramatic flair to say, you're celebrating an incomplete gift. I am living water. Anyone who comes to me will have rivers and streams of life, and it's never going to end. What is Jesus actually talking about? He's not going to fill you up with H2O unending. He's talking about his Spirit. He's talking about the presence of God living in you. And it's an inexhaustible source. You can't dry out the Spirit. It's always there. And he's promising that Spirit to anyone who would believe, to anyone who accepts the truth of Jesus. And this Spirit regenerates us to new life so that we can live in relationship with Jesus. It cleanses us of our sin and puts us in a position to reconnect with God. Now that is good news. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for your Spirit, that it is like a cool drink of water when our throats are dry and there's dust all in our lives. God, we thank you that you want to come and refresh our lives with your Spirit, and that we discover streams of life in relationship with you. Amen. Well, thank you for joining us, and until next time, we'll see you.